Good morning, students. So in today's class we are going to see the exponent number 6e, in which we are going to convert a decimal number into its hexadecimal equivalent, right? So welcome to this video lecture. I am Professor Shivanand Channi, ENC department, Jain College of Engineering, Belagavi, right? So moving to the next slide. So as usual, first we are going to discuss the algorithm to convert a decimal number into hexadecimal equivalent. Then we are going to see one example, then we are going to see the program, and we will see the snapshots of the result, right? So first, coming to the algorithm of this decimal to hexadecimal equivalent, the number input to this program is in decimal number, decimal, and the output is it's a hexadecimal equivalent, right? So when the number is called as a decimal number, if the number falls in between the range 0 to 99. So here we are dealing with only the 8-bit numbers, right? So the number must fall within the range 00 to 99, right? The number or the digit written or which falls in between the range of 0 to 9, then we can say the number is in decimal, right? So we are going to convert that into hexadecimal equivalent, right? So how this conversion is to be done, that we will see. First we will discuss the algorithm, right? How to convert this decimal to hex, right? So coming to the first step, the let us store one decimal number, which before going to the algorithm, first we will discuss what are the valid decimal numbers, right? 35, right? So 3 and 5 both falls in the range 0 to 9. 99, again they fall in the range, right? So A3 falls, but A doesn't fall in that range, so A3 is not qualified as the decimal number. You have 5 is not a decimal number, AB is not a decimal number, right? So only the decimal numbers are 35 and 99, because those two numbers are going to fall in this range 0 to 99, right? So now we will discuss the algorithm to convert decimal into hex, right? So store any one number in a RAM memory location, right? So any, you can store any number which falls between the range 00 to 99, right? So if I store that number into RAM memory location, the RAM memory location is, let us say, 50H. So this content of 50H is copied into accumulator first, right? So get that number into accumulator, right? So let us assume we will discuss. First we will see the hexadecimal number which is equal to decimal number which is equal to 68, right? So if I convert 68 into its hexadecimal equivalent, so what will be the result? 68, just divide it by 16, 16 fours are 64, and the remainder is 44. 44 is the hexadecimal equivalent of 68, right? So how to get this number, that we will see now, right? So what we will do, 68 is stored in one of the RAM memory location, so get that number into accumulator. So accumulator is filled with now 68, right? So next, mask the lower nibble and swap the content of accumulator, right? So what happens after masking? So masking means here we are going to make one of the nibble zero, right? So in the third step, we are going to mask the lower nibble, that become the lower nibble is 8 in this number, so we are going to mask it. That means 8 is going to become 0, right? So after masking, the content of accumulator will be equal to 60, right? So after swapping, next we are going to swap the content of accumulator. The accumulator is going to contain 06. What basically we are doing here, we are separating those two digits 6 and 8, then we are performing the conversion. So what we are going to get here is we got the digit which is at 10th place, right? So to convert that into its hexadecimal equivalent, so the hex, the digit at the 10th place is going to be multiplied with 0A, right? So if I multiply it with 0A, what we will get? 6 in decimal, it is 6 in decimal, A is written as 10, right? So 6 into 10 is 60. 60 is in decimal, but I want its hexadecimal equivalent converted to its hexadecimal equivalent. 16 threes are 48. 48. 60 minus 48 is what? 12. 12 in hex is written as C, right? So the hexadecimal equivalent of 60 is 3C. After multiplying 6 with 0A, we are going to get 3C, right? So this content, this will be the content of accumulator, and this content will be stored in one of the register, let us say R1, right? So now R1 contains what? R1 contains 3CH, right? So next, we are going to, that is the fourth step. Then fifth step, again get the original number, which was 68, which is present in 50H, again into accumulator, right? So put that number into accumulator. Then now we are going to mask the higher nibble, because now I want 08. So we will mask the higher nibble by adding with 0F, right? So if I add it with 0F, what we will get? We will get 08 in the accumulator, right? So what we have to do with this, we just add this unit place digit to the content of R1, right? So if I add the content of R1 to the content of accumulator, if I just add, what happens? C is 12. 12 plus 8 is 20 in decimal. If I convert 20 into hexadecimal, it will be equal to 14, right? So 3 plus 0 is 3 plus 1 is 4, right? So 44, what was the expected result, which was which is the hexadecimal equivalent of 68, right? So this 44 will be finally stored in one of the register, one of the RAM memory location. Let us assume that RAM memory location is 60H, okay? So I hope the algorithm is cleared. I even explained with the help of an example, right? So moving to the next slide, in which I have explained the same algorithm with an example. Here the example, the decimal number which is taken as 31H, right? So we are going to separate 31, right? So first we will get 303, then we will get 01, then we will multiply 03 with 0A. So what we will get? 10 into 3 is 30, 30 in hexadecimal is equal to 1E, right? So 1E, if I add the digit at unit place, which is equal to 01, if I add it with 1E, I am going to get the final result as 1F, right? So let us convert 31 into its hexadecimal equivalent. 16 ones are 16, the remainder is 15, and 15 is represented in hexadecimal as F. So the final result is 1F, which is the result expected, right? Which is the decimal hexadecimal equivalent of 31H, right? So this value will be finally, it will be stored in one of the memory location, right? So next, moving to the next slide, in which I have explained the program 8051 assembly language program to convert decimal number into its hexadecimal equivalent, right? So initially we are taking, where the program is getting started with 0000H, then we will move, the number is stored at the memory location 50H, in which the input is stored. So here assume the 31 is the number which is stored at 50H, right? So 31H is copied into the accumulator, right? Then we are adding the content of accumulator with F0H. That means we are masking the lower nibble. So lower nibble is masked and higher nibble is kept as it is, right? So after that, the content of accumulator will be swapped. The content of accumulator now is 30. After swapping, what we will get? We will get 03, right? So to this 03, we need to multiply 0A. 03 is multiplied by 03, right? For multiplication, we are going to use mul A, B. That means one operand must be in accumulator, second must be in register B, right? So put the accumulator contains one of the operand which is equal to 03. Now I need to put a second operand. The operand, second operand is 0AH. So that must be put in the register B, right? So if I put b 0a into b, then we can multiply the content of a and b by using mul instruction, right? So now if I multiply both the contents, then what we will get in the accumulator, we are going to get 1eh, because 10 into 3 is 30, 30 if I convert into decimal, hexadecimal, we will get 1eh, right? So this content of accumulator will be stored in one of the register. You can use any of the register from R0 to R7. Then we are going to store that result of content of accumulator into the register R1, right? So R1 is going to contain now 1eh, right? So next we will take again the original number which is stored at the 50h memory location into accumulator. So what is the content of R1 now? The content of R1 is 1eh, right? So now we are going to take again the original number into accumulator. The original number was 31h, right? So to this 31h, now I am going to mask the higher nibble by adding it with 0fh. If I mask it with 0fh, what we will get? We will get 01h. That is the digit present at the unit place, right? So which is present in the accumulator now. So no need to swap because we have already got the number, right? So in which the upper nibble is masked, right? So no need to swap here, right? So now the content of accumulator is 01. Now the content of R1 has to be added with the content of accumulator by using add instruction. So once I add, what will be the content of accumulator? It will be equal to 1fh, right? So content of accumulator is equal to 1fh. So that will be the final result of hexadecimal equivalent of 31h. So this content of accumulator will be stored finally in one of the RAM memory location. I hope the program of this conversion is clear to you. So moving to the next slide, I've included snapshots of the four results, right? So in the first window, the same number is taken, that is 31. 31 is the input which is stored at the 50h memory location. So after conversion, what we have? We have 1f as the hexadecimal equivalent of 31, which is stored at the memory location 60h. In the second window, the second number is 68, right? So if I convert 68 into hexadecimal, 16 fours are 64 and the remainder is 4. So 44 is the hexadecimal equivalent of 68. So that result you can see in the second window. In the third window, 99, convert that 99 into hexadecimal. You just take the input, convert that into hexadecimal and verify whether result is correct or no. So if I convert this into hexadecimal, 16 6 is 96 and the remainder is 3. So 63 is the hexadecimal equivalent of 99. And in the last window, 26 is converted into hexadecimal, which is equal to 1a, right? So I hope the algorithm and program of converting this decimal number into hexadecimal is clear to you. Okay, thank you.